The Castlefin Community Partnership Initiative dates back to 1999 when a meeting of representatives of various groups was held to set up an umbrella organisation to look at the needs of the community. The Castlefin Community Partnership Complex was opened in June 2007. As Centre Manager Michael Carlin explains, it's there to serve the local people.
We're trying to provide the best services and facilities possible for the people of Castlefin and the Fin Valley.
The €4 million centre includes a health centre, childcare facilities, multi-purpose hall, a development worker, computer training room, incubator units for new and small businesses, including a new community radio station, Fin FM, and a number of revenue-generating commercial units, including a pharmacy. Outside, there is a strong emphasis on education and attractions for children.
The idea of the centre is that the centre is an education trail the whole way around.
The centre is the home for the hugely successful Northwest Garden Show, the main fundraising event of the year. The most ambitious project to date is the White House Garden, designed by Chelsea Flower Show gold medal winner Dermot Gavin.
So we designed this garden as a gift from the people of Ireland to the people of America.
Castlefin Partnership Initiative Limited employs 6 people, with another 25 people employed indirectly. In the future, they hope to extend the hall. The CPI Centre has made a huge difference to the area. Donegal's tourism industry continues to have considerable potential, and in the Inishowen Peninsula, a dedicated company has been set up to promote all that is on offer. Inishowen Tourism is a community tourism forum serving over 150 businesses, as its manager Kathleen Gill explains.
Our main brief is to promote the region to become a top-class tourist destination, to market it nationally and internationally.
Inishowen Tourism works closely with tourism interests in Derry, taking advantage of the exposure gained by being the UK City of Culture. While these are difficult economic times, visitor numbers are up and she is optimistic about the future.
Going forward, if we can increase the number of visitors coming to the region, the economic spin-off from that is crucial to the survival of a lot of the businesses. We're seeing an increase year on year, this 2012 increased by 15%, so we're hopeful going forward that the numbers will increase.
Social media and the internet are being increasingly used for promotional purposes. And when it comes to tourist attractions, Inishowen is right up there.
It has everything. It has been often referred to as Ireland in miniature. It certainly has everything that a visitor looks for when they come to Ireland on holiday.
Inishowen Community Tourism employs 6 people, but this figure will grow as more visitors are attracted, notably from France, Germany and Britain.
And action.
In recent times, Inishowen has also featured in a number of film productions, and this is an area that offers real potential in the years ahead.
Shine a Rainbow and Grabbers has certainly caught the imagination of a number of directors on an international scale. So we're really looking forward to welcoming some more production teams into the area.
Letterkenny Community Childcare Limited is a not-for-profit registered charity that provides childcare facilities for children ranging from 6 weeks old to 10 years old. It has grown considerably over the last 30 years and is now located in modern premises in the Enterprise Business Park in Ballyrane. Geraldine Burke, the centre's coordinator, outlines the business.
We provide childcare for 109 children on 51 weeks of the year.
The centre was originally located in the Letterkenny Community Centre before moving to the current premises, which were opened in 2003. Designated a Centre of Excellence in 2008, Letterkenny Community Childcare boasts great facilities, both indoor and outdoor.
We have a baby room, we have a toddler room for the 2 to 3 year olds, we have 2 preschool rooms in this building for the 3 to 5 year olds and after school room, and then we have our sessional service in a new building that we just opened in September 12.
The centre has been a huge success. The centre now employs 21 staff, but this is set to rise, especially if there is further expansion.
The plan would be maybe in a couple of years' time to open another standalone baby unit for children from 0 to 2.